Hey guys, I'm Stephen Lowe, and today we're going over an interesting study called Concurrent Exercise Training: Do Opposites Distract? And so, if you've ever heard of the interference effect before, basically, if you're doing both resistance training and aerobic training, such as running, there's generally been an interference effect, which it has been proposed before and seen in practice, where you don't get the same gains that you would as if you had did them separately. So for example, if somebody is resistance training and doing it, and then right after they do some aerobic training, usually some of the gains will be blunted. And the reason for this is the cellular signaling pathways in the body. The strength and a hypertrophy pathway is called mTOR, so small m, big T, big O, big R. And it's the rapamycin pathway, basically. And basically, that signaling pathway, is, when it's activated, the other pathway, which is called AMPK, so big capital letters for all of them, big A, AMPK, those pathways, when one is turned on, the other is turned off. So it has been hypothesized before that doing one of them right after the other can interfere with each other, and that is why you get the traditional scientific evidence-based perspective that you should try to space sessions that are strength and aerobic at least 4 to 6 hours away from each other, so the signaling doesn't interfere with each other. So this is a 2017 study, I believe. And basically, they looked at concurrent training in novices versus more trained athletes. And what they found was that in the untrained athletes, there's actually no difference. So you could actually do strength training, then immediately run afterwards. So that is helpful. However, as you got more trained and more specialized towards strength and aerobic adaptations, such as moderately trained to months and years, you have a big divergence in single modal training and concurrent training, where you're doing both at the same time. And this kind of makes sense in that, an elite powerlifter, obviously, if they started running, their ability to recover is going to go down because they're using a lot of their recovery ability to now start running and improve those abilities. And obviously, the coordinating all of the muscle mass and such, which is mostly biased towards strength, you're obviously going to start tilting some of the muscle mass and metabolic adaptations towards aerobic adaptations. And so you start to lose some of the gains there. So, as you can see on the picture here, untrained is virtually similar. Moderately trained starts to diverge some. So generally month's timeline, you'll see some divergence. And then if you've been training for years, usually there is a solid maybe 15% interference effect there. It looks like maybe 15 to 20, 10 to 15 range of an interference effect, where your gains will be blunted if you try to put the sessions one right after the other. So this is why you kind of space out sessions in AM, PM, or you just do alternating days of them, like aerobic one day, resistance training the next day, rest, aerobic, resistance, rest, and so on. So let's look at some of their examples. Here is another example here. So when they tested endurance training, which is the blue one, in the untrained population, they showed that if they test they, when they did the untrained, they got about that blue line worth of adaptations. And actually, only doing just the endurance training, they tested the resistance training adaptations, and they even got some resistance training, which makes sense since someone who is running is getting some forceful impact into the ground compared to somebody who is sedentary. So you would expect a little bit of strength gain, even from those who are doing mostly endurance. Similarly, with the resistance train athletes in the red there on the top, you got a resistance effect where they improve mostly in resistance. But obviously, since lifting weights requires support of the cardiovascular system, And you can get out of breath if you're lifting high enough reps. There is some endurance gain on the opposite side when you just do resistance training. However, when they did the concurrent training, obviously you can see there, the endurance training plus the resistance training, they got both at once. Likewise, when they did tested the trained athletes, as you can see, the endurance trained only got a big blue bar there. But then when they did the resistance training, they got a big red bar. But when they did both together, actually the endurance training still made it out 100%. So this is good news for those endurance runners who just want to keep on improving. The endurance training gains weren't blunted by any of the resistance training. However, the resistance training gains were blunted by the concurrent training. So that's what we're looking for in terms of the interference effect. The general summary for this is if you're untrained, don't worry about it at all. However, if you're more specialized and in resistance training or you're trying to get stronger, generally, if you're more trained months to years, you're going to want to separate out your resistance training sessions from your endurance training or aerobic adaptations so your resistance training gains don't get blunted. So don't worry about it for beginners, but the more trained you are, you may have to do some scheduling issues to sort out potential blunting of gains there. So if you want to look at the study, I included it down at both slides, but overall, pretty simple to understand, and hopefully you learned a lot about the interference effect.